Hello fam, hello fam. Today we are having a DIY episode again. This time we need to flush the brake fluid on the front. With the track day that I was attending, my performance, especially when it comes to stopping, was poor. The brake pads are still fine. You might ask yourself, then what? So we were having the issues with the brakes. After two laps max, I had no brakes. And then once the brakes cooled down, then I've got brakes again. You see now it's cooled down nicely. I've got brakes, plenty. Just touch it like this, you are full brake. But right at the track where I was having trouble on stopping, especially after a few laps, because I was pushing the brakes so much. So I've just learned that as much as you service oil on your motorbikes and take out your oil after a certain period of time, you really, really, really need to do that as well on your brake fluids. So today we're gonna do a DIY. We're changing the fluid, putting in new fluid so that we can be able to be confident with our stopping and how we attempt the corners at the racetrack. So it's an easy one. This is what you need. So you're going to need a star screwdriver or a flat, depending on how your bike is locked up here. So this one is gonna go in there. That's why you need this. And then my one is using an 8 on the spanner. We're going to use the spanner right there on the bleeding nipple. And then I recommend you use a pipe to drain, especially if you are flushing, because we will be flushing the entire system. So it will be better to use a clear pipe, colorless pipe, so that we can see the fluid going out. We can see when the new one has reached the point. That's the aim. Hopefully it works fine. And then I've made a small reservoir there so that I just dump it in there, then I can close the bottle. And then the choice, the fluids are not the same. The fluids are not the same. So what you are running away from is actually, right now this part is cold. This is the part that becomes your enemy if you're using old brake fluid. So you've got brake fluid that flows from your brakes. It gets compressed in here, going straight to the calipers. And then from the calipers, they push in your cylinders to push the brake pad so that it stops. So now this part gets very hot when you're riding, especially if you are on a racetrack, because you stop time and again. There's too many corners. So it doesn't get that much time to cool down, and then you'll be on brakes again. So if that's the case, this part, as it gets very hot, it heats up your brake fluid. If your brake fluid is old, it's having a very low boiling temperature, what will happen is it will evaporate. Once it evaporates, or it forms steam inside your caliper, your pipe, because it's too hot. And then that's where you get spongy brakes. This thing comes up until you touch it here. It's really not nice. Sometimes you need to pump it at least twice or three times before you can feel you've got brakes. Your biggest enemy is the fluid. I've chosen this guy. This is the best I could get around my area. It's about $400. And then RBF 660 motor. So it can handle up until 325 degrees. dry boiling point. The dry boiling point is when the bottle is sealed and then you hoi it or put it in the reservoir right here and it's sealed. Once you store it on the garage and it absorbs some moisture and all that, it's wet boiling point. So if this thing can go up until 325 and this won't evaporate, then you'll have breaks while this calipers are very hot. So that's my biggest blunder in a way that happened on the racetrack. And then I've got the dirty cloth there because we're going to drain it from here on the nipple. So this can be opened. I'll take you through, and then I think you'll just watch the video. So what we're going to do is we're going to plug this pipe right here. We're going to push it in there, and then I'll try to hang it out vertically so that we can see the fluid coming out to the reservoir. And then we're going to put this guy, which is my spanner, right here. And then we pump, we hold like this, we open the valve, and then it drains out. We pump, we open like this, and then we will keep on refilling it right there on the reservoir up until all the pipes have got new fluid. Up until all these pipes have got new fluid. So it's the left, sorry, it's the right, this one. And we've got the left hand side. So normally they say you need to start from the one that is further. With my bike, nothing is further because they are both equal. So I can start on any side, it's okay. And then from there, we'll take it for a spin and see if everything went well. So I'll just move the camera a bit back and then you'll watch everything. But yeah, it is as simple as that. We'll keep on refilling using this one, which is the racing brake fluid. I was told it's very, very good. Some other places, they've got RBF 700 now, which is much even higher temperatures, but this is good enough. Not a professional race. I'm not racing for money or anything. I just want to enjoy the track and perform as much as I can. So, voila. Let's get to it. Please don't judge me. I bought this thing because I use it to fix other things. This is not what you think, man. Yeah. So I forgot to mention that you don't need to pump the entire fluid that's left on the reservoir through your pipes. You can just drain it. Just leave a little bit. Don't drain it fully. Just leave a little bit and then start filling it up with the new one, and then we will keep on pumping it through. So this, I'm using this to actually suck liquids where I can't reach, or when I get rid of certain liquids. That's what I use this for. It has never been used somewhere where it's intended to go. No. So this is what you need to use. You need to try and get it to at least minimum, because it's gonna give us a lot of work if we're trying to pump it through. But it's better if we just drain a little. So it's not completely out. I've just leave a little. We'll start filling in with a new one and then continue. As you can see, it's still sealed. This is what they mean when they say dry. Doesn't have any moisture and all, but it's still sealed. To get you closer, but this is what we are getting currently. This is what we're getting. So let's continue and see. Guys, you keep on pumping. You keep on pumping. You can take breaks. I think you see our reservoir there is dropping. But keep on pumping. As you can see, this is the dirty fluid that took out. It's quite black actually, but I've noticed that on the line, I'm now taking out clean fluid. So this is what you want to see. If this is the case, you're now taking out clean fluid, then you need to move to the other side. So, once you are confident that you are now taking out clean fluid, then you can release the slack so that it drops completely. Oh no, I'm speeding now. it's a matter of filling the reservoir. Look at the difference. Let's get some focus here and see if we do. Yes. Look how clean it is. This is the new one. This is the new one. Pipes looks clean. Guys, that's why I was saying you color this pipe. Look at that. That's dirty. That's surely enough. I'm sure we've drained everything right now. So we're good to go. And that's how simple it is. Just fill up just a bit, but now we know our fluid is new. Guys, I ended up deciding to do the back as well. Look what I found. That's how black it is. Getting there. The bag was more terrible. Hello guys, you can treat this as part two of bleeding the brakes. So what's happening is with the S1000RR, this is for the guys who are using the S1000RRs or the guys who are having the bleeder nipple on top of the inlet pipe for brake fluid on their calipers. If you notice here, you've got this pipe. This is what we were bleeding. There's new fluid here, but what about the fluid that is still inside the calipers? What about the fluid that is in here? Because the brakes that are spongy that you are getting, they are because this caliper breaks and then it gets hot and then it boils this liquid that is currently here. That's why you are having spongy. So if you bleed up until here and you don't do the calipers, then you still have brake fluid on your calipers, which is old. Then you will feel like you didn't do a good job, only to find that you also needed to take this one out. With the other bikes, it's simple, because you get this side, you get your inlet, the other side, you get the bleeder nipple. So automatically all the fluid that will come out on the bleeder nipple, it will have ran through your calipers, so it's easy. But with the S1000, you need to open your blade.
What you need to do here is to press your brakes or your brakes cups. There's cups inside here. They need to shift back fully so that they compress everything that's here out the bladder nipple. Then you will know for sure there was no brake fluid that is old on your brake calipers. All right. Now, same procedure again. We open at the top. I think we need to first take this caliper out. Can you put this back? Just hang them right here. So that your caliper leans on it. And then that's where now you need to open your reservoir there at the top so that you can see everything. Reservoir being open, I need a way to block and press my brake pads. So yeah, this thing I will need screwdrivers. So what makes sense to me now is to put this tool right here. I'm going to turn them in to push those cups, the stuff that pushes the brakes back there, to push it back in. And then my pipe here will be filling with dirty fluid from the cups. Then we will be sure that we've drained all the fluid, and the fluid that's new, it's the one that's here. Ooh. Now I'm just taking the pads out to make sure that these cups are fully pressed. As I'm pressing them, the fluid on my pipe is clanging. Once you're fully pressed, you can lock your dressing hook.
It's having brick fluid. I've closed it now. But all this dirty fluid that was still stuck in here. So yeah, it's something to add on. Here we go. So we're just making sure that all the fluid that was in there, it's not in there. Yeah. Okay. That's what you just need to add up. I will clean this for the video. I just wanted to make sure that you understand that this cylinders here, which we call them the cups, they are fully pressed in. Then you know that you don't have fluid in here, so you've taken it all out. Okay, and yeah, that's it. I think that was the last part. Thanks for watching.